Let me put this on record. I am so happy my guru's samadhis are getting built beautifully. I have built it in a small way, but I wanted it to be done in a big way, like a full-fledged temple. As of now, we built it like a small mandapam. See, to build an ashram for me, I know they went from shop to shop, house to house, literally begged and built a first ashram for me. But I don't need to beg. They have showered me with wealth. They have given me so many powers, so much of knowledge. They made sure I learned the science of making organization. Now, there is so much wealth all of you have given me. So I should build at least a decent level memorial for all of them. Because their tyaga, their sincere work need to be remembered. The whole world should remember. I should say around 100 people. All their hard work, sincere work is the result. I am the result of all their sincere work. At least 100 people. I'll add all their photographs, all their relics, Pushpa Samadhi, everything I'll immortalize beautifully in Thiruvannamalai Ashram with all their photographs, whatever is available. Now, the items they used in their life, everything I'll collect and nicely organize and build their samadhis. This is the only small way I can give my gratitude to them. But the whole ecosystem of Arunachala should be remembered, celebrated. I celebrate my mother because she was ferocious with me. Hey, don't think she is powerless woman. She may be very silent. But when it comes to training me, my gurus are the absolute authorities. Neither she will interfere, nor she will disrespect them. She will not even listen to my complaints to her about my gurus. The moment I start telling, oh, Raghupati Yogi is making me do 1008 Suri Namaskar, she will start doing her cooking. Till then, she will be talking to me nicely. She'll be joking with me, laughing. And I used to be very, that cuddly, cuddly boy. All the time cuddling her and having my hands on her shoulder or holding her pallu. That kind of a mom's boy. She'll be talking very nicely with me, laughing, joking, responding, teasing. But the moment I try to complain about my gurus, she will just turn her head and start cooking. I know. Now I have to just keep quiet. Even one day she will not allow me to miss my classes with my gurus. She will never bother to send me to school. And she knows I cheat, I don't go to school. And she will never ask me. From school, so many times teachers will come and tell, he's not coming to school. She will never ask me about it and she will manage them. My progress report from the school, it will always come with a 0-0 because I never attend the examination. So how will they put any mark? I never go to any exams. So when I take my progress report to my father, he will say, "Niye kayit putkada?" He will tell, "You yourself sign. What is there for me to sign?" I used to tell, "No, I don't know how to put signature." So she will put his hand on all the mark, and he will not look at any of these mark columns, anything. He will just sign. He will look only at the column where he has to sign, and he will sign and tell, "Hey, take it and go. That's all." But she will never miss even one day my class with my gurus. She had an amazing understanding about what I am going to become. She is the witness for all the training I went through with my gurus, the sincere work of my gurus. And I know by the time I was 10, 12, I started realizing that she and my gurus are in hand in hand. They have a tight network and understanding about each other more than me. So I stopped complaining. What is there? Even if I tell, she is not going to listen. The extreme sincerity of my gurus, the way they never gave up, never compromised, never reduced the intensity of their training,